Earlier today, the Therapeutic Goods Administration, Professor Skerritt, announced that they had approved the Pfizer vaccine for people aged over 16 years here in Australia. I note that this is not an emergency approval, as has been done in some other jurisdictions around the world. This is a formal approval under the ordinary processes of the TGA.
It's approved now for Australians 16 years of age and older. I think when last we spoke, we were anticipating it might be 18 years and older. And so that's a broader range of population than anticipated. That changes our vaccination strategy. So as those 16 and above will now be included in phase 2B. The commencement remains on track for February, as the Prime Minister has said. The completion remains on track for October. This approval by the TGA is one of the earliest in the world for a full approval. First vaccines in Australia ready for distribution in late February, so within the guidance that we'd previously provided, that's likely to start with approximately 80,000 doses per week, if not more.
But the vaccine is registered for all ages over 16, but there will be specific advice that ATAGI will be producing around particularly people who are very frail and, you know, close to end of life, which is that group that had the issues in Norway.
It is important to understand that once the vaccines start, that doesn't mean you can jump on a plane to Bali the next day. It doesn't mean that the masks disappear if that's what the public health arrangements are in a particular state or territory, or the quarantine arrangements for return into Australia will end, or anything like this. This will build. It'll start at small scale. It'll build up, and it'll happen over a period of time as we've outlined over the course of this year.